श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोपीनाथ श्याम को राधा कुंडन की जय। श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। श्री मायापुर नवदीप धाम की जय। श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा की जय। गंगा माई की जय। जमुना माई की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। तुलसी महारानी की जय। श्री श्री कृष्ण बलराम की जय। श्री श्री राधा श्याम सुंदर की जय। श्री श्री गौरताई की जय। गौर प्रेमानंद। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामी इति नाम्नि। Namaste Saraswat Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Pashyade Satarine Vansha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyascha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasa Yogunakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya respectful obeisances at your lotus feet, all the Vaishnavas. Please have your mercy on me. His Holiness Param Sardhaya Mahavishnu Maharaj put his responsibility on my soul, so to speak. Actually, he was supposed to speak today, but he ordered me to speak, so please forgive me. I am very happy to see you all, the Vaishnavas here. And I am trying to give English class here just after 1 year. The same place I spoke in English. But in India I spoke only Hindi, Hindi class, Hindi class. Just after 1 year I am speaking English. So, in India, at one place, I spoke the story of Ajamil, in which the glorification of the Holy Name is given. By Śrīla Śukadeva Goswami and by the Vishnu Dutas and by Jamraj, three authorities speak on the glorification of Holy Name. But just after hearing this topic, Maharaj Parikshit put a very wonderful question to Śrīla Śukadeva Goswami that I want to speak on that subject. Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami about the sub-creation. He heard in third canto that Lord Brahma created so many living entities, but he spoke very briefly, very sanskrit. And he began to explain how Lord Kapila Dev instructed Mahabhagara Devahuti. And then he left the description of creation. And at the end of fourth canto, he was speaking about the history of Prasetas, the sons of King Prachinbarhi. So here in sixth canto, Parikshit Maharaj is inquiring again. Sri Rajavacha. Deva Surindranam Sargo Naganam Rigapakshinam Samasika Stoya Prakto Yastu Swayam Guantare Tasaiva Vyasam Ichami Gyatunte Bhagavan Jatha Amsargam Jaya Shaktya Sasarja Bhagavan Paraha. Translation. The Blessed King said to Sukadeva Goswami, my dear Lord, the demigods, demons, human beings, nagas, beasts and birds were created during the time of Swambhuva Manu. You have spoken about this creation briefly in the third canto. Now I wish to know about it elaborately. I also wish to know about the potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead by which He brought about the secondary creation. In Śrīmad Bhagavatam, there are 10 subjects. Atra sarva visargascha sthanam poshana mutaya manvantaresa nukatha nirodho muktirasraya. First is sarga. Sarga means the creation by the Supreme Personality of Godhead directly. The creation of 5 gross elements like earth, water, fire, air and ether. And also the creation of mind, intelligence and false ego. This is called sarga, the first creation by the Supreme Personality of God. And visarga means creation by Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma created so many living entities with the help of the ingredients provided by the Supreme Lord. The creation by God is called sarga, and secondary creation by Lord Brahma is called visarga. So Maharaj Parikshit now asking how Lord Brahma created so many living entities. Please explain me. We should contemplate on this point how Maharaj Parikshit is eager to hear about creation. Because this creation belongs to Krishna Himself, the Supreme Lord Himself. So actually when we hear His creation, in this way we develop our love for Him and we lose the feelings that we are master of this material world. When we hear creation, then we have no more feeling or this tendency to lord it over material nature or to become enjoyer like that. So this is necessary to hear. Maharaj Parikshit was to give up his body just after 4 days, but he is so interested in hearing the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To create, to maintain and to annihilate this material world is the very wonderful activity of the Supreme Personality of God. So he is asking Lord Brahma created some living entities, but he spoke this thing very briefly, but now tasaiva vyasam ichhami gyatum te bhagavan jatha anusargam jaya shaktya sasarja bhagavan paraha. How Lord Brahma created all living entities, anusargam. Anusargam means sub-creation. How he created and which potency he created, jaya, saktya and jatha. Jatha means prakaram, jatha prakaram, how he created and by which potency, by which energy he created. Sut Goswami addressed the sense of Naimisharanya. Iti samprasnama karanya rajarse vadarayani pratinanda mahajogi jagada munisattama. Sut Goswami said, O great sages at Naimisharanya, after great yogi Sukadev Goswami heard King Parikshit's inquiry, he praised it and thus replied. Then Maharaj Parikshit inquired about the creation. Sukadev Goswami was very pleased. He was satisfied and he appreciated the question by Maharaj Parikshit. He appreciated in this way that you have asked a very nice question. Thank you very much. And he began to speak. We have read the story of Prasadam in fourth canto. Sukadeva Goswami begins from there. Jada prachetasa putra dasa prachina varisha anta samutra unmagnam dadrasurgam drumer vritam. When the 10 sons of King Prachin Varhi named Prachetas came out from the ocean, they saw that the whole surface of the earth was overrun, covered with trees, because their father, King Prachin Varhi, was instructed by Narad Muni, so he was thus elevated and he left his kingdom and went to the ashram of Lord Kapil there, where Mother Ganga meets ocean, Ganga Sagar, that is called. This is the effect of pure preaching. Narad Muni instructed King Prachin Varhi by describing the story of Puranja, very famous story in Śrīmad Bhagavatam. He explained the purports of the story, purports behind the story. So Raja Prachin Varhi left his kingdom. Before leaving kingdom, he wrote a letter to his sons. Actually, his sons were at that time inside ocean, Narayan Sarovar, and they were performing very severe austerity to please the Supreme Personality God. And they were 10, and they were all called Pracheta. Pra means significant, or pra means precursor. Actually, pra means superior, and here pra means beyond material nature, and cheta means consciousness, pracheta. Those 10 sons were highly Krishna conscious person. So they had no any interest in worldly things. They did not like to enjoy this material world. They were performing austerity inside water, in Narayan Sarovar, that was in the ocean. So when they emerged from water, they saw the whole world was filled with trees. Everywhere trees. Because King Prachin Varhi also left the kingdom. So there was no any manager to guide citizens or subjects to produce food grains. There was no any arrangement of agriculture. King left kingdom and his sons left before he left. So actually there was arajakta. In Sanskrit it is called a means not, no, and rajakta means king, say, or king. There was no any king at that time. So there was no agriculture, Srila Prabhupada has written. If there was no agriculture, no cultivation of land, so everywhere only trees, trees. So when a Pracheta came out of the ocean, they remembered the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Actually, the Supreme Lord, Sri Hari, ordered them to beget children. He ordered them to marry. And very wonderful thing is this, that the Lord ordered them 10 brothers to marry with one girl. Very wonderful thing. The Lord said, you are 10, but you have the same feature of body, same consciousness, same speaking style, everything same. So, actually you are 1 in 10. You are not 10, you are 1. So you can marry with one girl and beget children. And also King Prachinbar, he wrote a letter to his sons that please you marry and just look after the management of the kingdom. So when they came out of the ocean, they saw the surface of globe was, earth was full of trees. They became very angry about trees. They became very angry. Just see, they had the darshan of the Supreme Lord. They performed austerity 10,000 celestial years. And then they saw the Supreme Lord face to face. The Lord blessed them with so many benedictions. But when they came out of the ocean, they were very angry on trees. So they generated fire and wind from their mouths. Drumibhya kudhamanaste tapo didit manyava. Their anger was inflamed by austerity. Srila Prabhupada has written that those who perform austerity, it is seen that they become angry very easily. Because they think, I am sadhu, I am great person, so they become angry. Tapo dipit manyavan. Dipit means inflamed, and tapo means austerity, penance. We have also seen some sadhus in India actually. They are really tapasvi but very angry. On slight matter they become angry. But actually, Pracheta were very highly Krishna conscious person. This anger was not ordinary. So they became angry and they generated fire and wind from their mouths and began to burn the trees to ashes. So when there was fire, 10 persons were generating fire and wind from their mouths. So everywhere there was fire and very fast wind. So many trees were burning. When the predominating deity of the moon planet or the master of trees and plants, Som, saw that trees were being burned. He became very compassionate to trees and he appeared before Prachetas and he pacified them, he requested them. So here actually this time what I want to speak, that is the matter, how Som is instructing Prachetas. That is the main subject today we have to discuss. Prachetas were very great devotees of the Supreme Lord, but for time being they became angry on trees. In their heart, they actually wanted to increase the population. So they wanted to produce some grains for the food of the human entities. But they were unnecessarily burning trees. This was not necessary. So this is seen in Śrīmad Bhagavatam when Dhruva Maharaj heard that his brother was killed by Jaksha. He became angry and he killed so many Jakshas. And at the end, Manu Maharaj pacified him. He instructed him. Then he stopped fighting. And also we see that Maharaj Prithu, he became angry on Mother Earth. And he was running after her to kill her. But Mother Earth requested Prithu Maharaj, don't kill me. Just follow the path of the previous acharyas. Just cultivate me and then I will give milk. Then Maharaj Prithu was pacified. So in the same way, Prachetas were born in the same dynasty. Dhruva Maharaj, then after some generations came Prithu Maharaj, then Prachin Barhi, then Prachetas, the same dynasty. They were very great persons, exalted persons. Anger arose in their mind, but very quickly they finished. They became very peaceful, very quickly. This is the siddhant that when a great personality become angry, but their anger does not exist so long. In one slok, in one verse it is said that how long a great person remains angry, how long? As long as the offender does not touch his feet. Kopah pranama avadhi. His kop, his anger exists as long as one does not touch his feet. When the offender offers obeisance, then his anger is off. This is the greatness of a great person. Dhruva Maharaj was like that, and Prithu Maharaj, and Prachetas also. So, Som, who is the master of trees and vegetables, he is instructing Prachetas. This instruction is very nice. Everyone should accept this teaching, these teachings. Som said, Mantrumebhyo Mahabhaga Mahabhaga Dinebhyo Drogdumarhata Vivartai Savoyam Prajanam Pataya Smritaha. O greatly learned, O greatly fortunate ones, you should not kill these poor trees by burning them to ashes. Your duty is to wish the citizens all prosperity and to act as their protectors. Some said, you are Mahabhaga, very great fortunate persons, very fortunate. Because some knew that they have gotten the darshan, they have got the darshan of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and they have talked with Him directly, they have seen Him face to face. So they were very fortunate persons, Mahabhaga. Oh, greatly fortunate ones, Srila Prabhupada is translated, very fortunate. So you should not kill these poor trees. This is not your duty. Your duty is to protect citizens, not to kill them. And actually, human beings or beasts, trees, birds, everyone is citizen in the kingdom of a king. So this is the duty of a king to protect everybody, and no one should be killed unnecessarily. The first thing is that Prachetas were Vaishnav, very high class Vaishnav. So this is not befitting them to burn trees. You are Prajapataya, you are the protector and maintainer of Prajas, subjects, citizens. Everyone knows, and also the Supreme Lord has said that you are Prajapati. Pati means a protector. In Sanskrit, a husband is also called Pati. Pati means Pati iti Pati. Pati means Rakshati, one who protects a woman is called Pati. Pati means he protects and maintains his wife, so he is called Pati. He protects his wife with any from any danger, and he provides cloth, ornaments, house and children to his wife. So he is Pati. Otherwise he is not a Pati, he is not a husband. This is the definition of Pati. Prajapati means the palak, the protector and maintainer of citizens. So you are Prajapati, but you are not protecting trees. Trees are also Praja. They are also subjects. And you should just think that why the Supreme Personality of Godhead created trees and plants, herbs. Why He created? What was purpose? Aho Prajapati Patir Bhagavan Hari Rabhyayaha. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, is Abhyaya, indestructible master of all living entities. His Prajapati Pati, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Hari, is the master of all living entities, and even He is the master of all Prajapatis, headed by Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma is called Prajapati, and his sons, just like Daksh Prajapati and Angira, Bhrigu, Pulaha, Kratu, they are also Prajapati, because they have also generated so many living entities. and they have protected, still they protect, they maintain, so they are also Prajapati. There are so many Prajapati, there are so many masters of different living entities, but the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, is the Prajapati Pati, Bhagavan. So he created Vanaspati Osadhinsta, he created trees and vegetables, grains, to maintain other living entities, to nourish them, to feed them. This is the arrangement of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Before giving birth to human beings or even animals, he created trees, plants first. And these trees and plants and herbs are the food for other living entities. Not only food, in Sanskrit actually anna means food, and also anna means support. Just like trees, we do not only eat fruit from trees, but also we are in the shelter of a tree. In America I have seen that most of houses are made of woods. Wood comes from tree. Actually trees are giving shelter to human beings. They are the shelter. From woods houses are constructed, so many things. This wood is helping us as table. We cannot use any human being just like table. But everywhere we can see how trees are very, very helpful in our life, everywhere. So God has created trees to maintain other living entities. The trees and plants, they give energy, just like wheat or chana, grams, chana, matar, so many sabjis. They are all produced from some plants, from trees, either dry fruits or wet fruit. From where these dry fruits come? They all come from trees, vanaspati. And some thing, just like sabji comes from plants, and grains also come from plants. So these plants and trees are very helpful. They are helping us to survive. They are maintaining us. So this is the arrangement, this is the intelligence of the Supreme Lord, how He is maintaining other living entities. So, O Pracheta, don't think that these trees have less importance in this creation. Why you are burning them? This is unjust, this is not good. Actually, everywhere we see trees. But in human society, this education is lacking. No one considers how beneficial are these trees. And so we should give them also respect, and we should not cut them unnecessarily. Everywhere we should see the arrangement of the Supreme Lord. When we eat any fruit, we can just consider how this fruit has come in existence, how. From human beings, no one fruit comes actually. Nothing. Only they know how to eat. How to eat. They eat animals, they eat fruits, they eat grains, they eat everything. They can eat everything actually, all educated persons. I have heard that in China, they eat monkeys. Also serpents, monkeys, and also they eat a very tender child from the womb, making juice. This is the uncultured society actually. But in Śrīmad Bhagavatam, very elevated education is given. So much instructing prasetas that the Supreme Personality of Godhead created all these trees, plants and herbs to help other living entities, especially human beings. So, annam charanam acharahya padah padacharinam ahasta hasta yukta nam dvipadam cha chatuspadah. This is nature's arrangement that fruits and flowers are food for insects and birds. Annam charanam achara. Achara means fruits and flowers. Achara. Chara means to move. Those who don't move. Just like trees, they do not go from one place to another place. They do not move. And flowers, grass. So fruits and flowers, achara, are the food of chara. Chara means those who have wings to fly. Insects and birds, they eat flowers and fruits, and thus they maintain themselves. Yapadah padacharinam. And for padacharinam, those who move on legs, just like cows and buffalo, they eat grass. This is the arrangement of God. God has supplied so many grass, so much grass on this earth. And so cows and buffalo, they eat grass, and ahasta hasta yuktanam. And those who have no hast, no hand, they are the food of those living entities who have hands. It means there are some animals, their front legs are used as hands, just like tigers and lions. They have legs, but front legs, they work as hands. So they are called sahast. Sa means with, hast means hand, with hand. They attack on cows and other animals. So those animals who have no hands, they are the food of sahastana. The animals, those who have hands. This is the arrangement of God. And dvipadam cha chatuspada. And those who have only two legs, they have the food. Their food are four-legged animals. Srila Prabhupada has written so nice purport on this verse. Four-legged animals are food of two-legged men. Dvipadam cha chatuspada. But Srila Prabhupada is translating that deers and goats are the food of human beings. But in purport he said that actually those who are very highly elevated human beings, just like Brahmins, Kshatriyas and Vaisyas, they do not eat meat. Only Sudras eat meat, but they eat only deers and goats never carbs. Those who eat cow, they are the lowest human beings actually on this earth. This is very sinful activities, very sinful. And chatuspada, the four-legged animals, actually they are meant to help human beings. Food does not mean only eatables, but actually a human being can use cows for milk, bulls for agriculture, ass for carrying a load, and horses. These are all four-legged animals. He can use them in agriculture, in transporting, or he can use them as yan. Yan ko kya kahenge? Sawari kar sakta hai.
Vehicle.
This is the meaning behind this verse. So this is the arrangement of God everywhere. And again Som said, Yuyam cha pitra madhishta dev devena chanagha prajarat sargaihi katham priksham nirdagdha marat. And you are ordered already by your father to create, to maintain. And also the Supreme Personality of Godhead has ordered you to create and maintain citizens. Then why you are killing? King Prachinbari did not tell you to kill, to burn trees, and also the Supreme Personality of Godhead directly ordered you to create, to maintain, to increase the population. He has ordered thus, but you are doing just the contrary to the order of God. This is not good. Yojami pitra madhishta, pitra anu adhishta, your father has ordered you to create praja sargaya. O pure hearted ones, anag, nispap, I know you have not committed any sins, you are pure hearted, but just you remember, I remind you, the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and the order of your father. Just remember, and you should not burn trees unnecessarily. Briksha nirdagdha marat. Why you are envious of trees? In this material world, actually trees are the example. As a Mahatma, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said that these trees are the guru of Vaishnavas. Taro riva sahishvana. One should tolerate like trees. They tolerate everything. They tolerate the torrents of rain, they tolerate colds, heats, everything. And they maintain human beings and animals. So this is very sinful to disturb or to kill trees. This is very painful thing. Just we can imagine how great a teaching is given in Śrīmad Bhagavatam. If Som is instructing that one should not destroy trees unnecessarily, then what we speak of killing cows and animals? We should remember Prabhupada's instructions, and as we are his disciples, we must try to propagate these teachings just propagate. Actually, there are so many persons who do not know that cow killing is sinful. They do not know actually. And sometimes they say animals have no soul. This gross ignorance. The mood. It means they do not know the symptom of consciousness, symptom of soul. We speak, animals also speak. We have seen that when an animal is in some crisis, some danger, he screams. We can understand that he is screaming for protection. But those who say that animals have no soul, actually they have no soul. Their heart is made of wood or stone, wood dust. They are ass actually. How they say this thing? Even trees have souls. Grasses have souls. What we speak of animals and birds. So Swami is instructing that your father and the Supreme Lord have ordered you to maintain, to protect, to increase the number of population. Then why you are burning these trees? Adhishthata satam margam kopam yachata dipitam pitra pitamahe napi justam vahpra pitamahai. The path of goodness traversed by your father, grandfather and great-grandfathers is that of maintaining the subjects, including the men, animals and trees. This is the path you should follow. Unnecessary anger is contrary to your duty. Therefore, I request you to control your anger. Atishthata satam margam. You should just stick on the path of satam, great persons, and especially that path which is followed by your father, Prasin Barhi, grandfather, Maharaj Prithu, and great grandfathers like Dhruv Maharaj, etc. They were very great persons. They maintained praja. They protected, they maintained citizens very well. So you should stick to that path. And please subdue your anger. Don't become angry and don't kill these trees. Otherwise, this anger can destroy your whole life. They were very elevated devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but still so much instructive that and to become angry is not good. Lord Krishna has said in Bhagavad Gita that the three things, kaam, krodh and lobh, are the gateway to hell. Trividham narkasyedam dvaram nasanam atmana. These three, kama, krodhas, tathar, lobhas, tasma, deta, trayam, tyajet. This kama, the unnecessary lusty desires and unnecessary greed and unnecessary anger spoils one's life. Nasanam atmana. They kill the soul. Killing soul means they just cover the knowledge of the living entity. And living entity at that time does not know who he is, what is his duty, what is his relationship with God. He forgets everything. When a person becomes too lusty, he cannot understand, he cannot remember his duty. And if he is too greedy, not satisfied whatever he has, And he cannot remember the Supreme Personality of Godhead or his relationship with him. This is called Atmana Nasana. Although the soul cannot be killed, but soul's consciousness can be polluted. And if our consciousness is polluted, that is the nas of the Atma. And at last, what will be destination of Kami, Krodhi and Lobhi? The destination will be hell. Narkasyedam trividham dvaram. The Lord has said. So, Swami requests him, please subdue your anger. And this anger is the path to hell. The duty of a king is to protect his citizens and maintain his citizens. To support this idea, Swami is giving five examples. Tokanam pitarau bandhu. Father and mother are the friends and maintainers of their children. This is first example. Fathers and mother are naturally protector and maintainer of their children. How father and mother can become envious of their children? You are like father and mother for citizens, for trees, or birds, or animals, for everyone. So why you are killing them? Fathers and mothers are the friends and maintainer of their children. Tokanam pitaram and bandhu, drisah pakshma, and eyelids are the protector of eyes. We see every day these eyelids, when we make tilak, we can see. How they protect eyes, how the eyelid protects eyes. Always blinking. Always blinking. This blinking means protecting eyes. It's like wiper, wipes dust and any things. And if anyone puts even his own finger inside the eyes, the eyelid does not allow. The eyelid just covers the and protects eye. Pakshma drisam. In this way, this is the duty of a king to protect citizens, just like eyelid protects eye. This is the example. And in Śrīmad Bhagavatam, it is said that Lord Krishna protects his devotee, just like eyelid protects eye. If a person just brings some pain or anything near the eyes, the eyelid just blocks the way, just covers. It never allows to disturb eyes. In this way, a king should protect his citizens. This second example, Striyapati. Just as a husband protects and maintains his wife, in this way a king should protect his citizens. The real friend of a woman is her husband. Striyah Pati. The real friend, bandhu, protector, maintainer of a woman is her husband, Striya Pati. Pati Prajanam Bhikshunam Grihi. And Grihi, a householder, is the real friend and maintainer of Bhikshuna, beggars. Beggars means here sannyasis and brahmans, brahmacharis. The Grihast is the friend, bandhu of sannyasis, beggars, samsaris, brahmas. We see here that so many sadhus are coming to grihasthas. They take shelter. And this is the duty of a grihastha to feed sadhus, brahmans, and give them clothes. And give them some prayers also to go here and there. This is the duty of grihasthas. Grihi bhikshura. There are some persons still in India who do not earn any money. Some brahmanas and sannyasis and some beggars. Srila Prabhupada has said they are not professional beggars. But this is the duty of grihastha to maintain, because sannyasis and brahmanas, they do not earn money. But anyhow, they should be maintained. They cultivate Krishna consciousness. They write some books. They do so many things. It's like I was reading today, Jadwal Prabhu gave me one paper. He's doing so nice works. So in this way, this is the duty of a grihastha, to maintain those persons who are full-time devoted in Krishna consciousness, but they do not earn money. Grihi means a householder, bhikshuna, agyanam buddha smrita, and the learned is the real friend, bandhu of those who are ignorant. He should teach them, he should give them knowledge. Here five examples are given by some. Father and mothers are bandhu of children, and eyelid is the bandhu. Bandhu means well-wisher or protector of eye, and husband is the well-wisher and bandhu, suhird, of his wife. And grihastha, householder, is the friend, suhird, maintainer of brahmanas, sannyasis, brahmacharis, and beggars. And a learned person is the suhird, maintainer, bandhu of ignorant souls. In this way, a king is the suhird, maintainer, protector of his citizens. So he should protect, he should not kill any living entity. And another thing, antardeheshu bhutanam atmaste bhagavan hari sarvam tad dhrishnamikshadham esa vastositam yasav. Even vastositam yasav, every living entity is the residence or temple of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So you should see this thing. Antardeheshu bhutanam atmaste bhagavan hari. The Supreme Personality of Godhead resides in the course of the hearts of every living entity. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hridayesu arjun tishtati. So if we kill any living entity, we must see that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is within his body. Antardeheshu. Antardeha means inside body, in the heart, the Supreme Personality of Godhead resides as super soul. So if we destroy any body, it means we are destroying the temple of God. Yes. So, sarvam tad dhrishnam ikshadvam, you should see everyone's body as the residence or temple of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. By this vision, you can please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is very high thinking actually. In Śrīmad Bhagavatam, everywhere this is given. The first class devotee is one who sees or who beholds God everywhere, in every living entity. Param Bhagavat or Mahabhagavat. And actually this is very true. Everywhere in Gita's, Lord Krishna has said that I am in every living entity's heart. Sarvasya chaham hrudi sannivishta matta smrti gyan pahma pohananj. I am in the heart of every living entity. Isvara sarva bhutanam hrudi sannivishta. You can see the Lord is using word sarva, sarva. Sarvasya chaham hrudi sannivishta. Isvara sarva bhutanam hrudi sannivishta. Sarva bhutanam. Not only in human beings, but sarva bhutanam. In every living entity's heart I dwell. I reside. So, seeing the Supreme Lord in everyone's heart, you should not kill any living entity unnecessarily. Now he is instructing that this growth, this anger, how it comes. Yah samutpatitam dehe akasan manyamurvaram Atma-jigyāsaya ajat-chet sa-guṇānati vartate. One who inquires into self-realization and thus subdues his powerful anger, which awakens suddenly in the body as if falling from the sky, transcends the influence of the modes of material nature. How anger comes. If some is saying, this comes akasmat. Akasmat. Kasmat means, kis karan se, how? If we cannot know how, this is called akasmat. Akasmat, akasmic. Krodh becomes akasmic. The anger becomes suddenly, it seems just like as it falls from the sky within our body. It seems like that. Ya samutpatitam dehe akasan manyum ulvaram. This ulvaram means powerful. How powerful is anger? We can see when a person becomes angry. The anger pervades his whole body. First anger awakens, comes in eyes first. When one becomes angry, we can see his eyes and he cannot cover the anger. It may be that he cannot speak in anger, but his eyes indicate that he is angry now. And after eyes, the anger comes at tongue. And when anger comes on tongue, then it spreads in whole body. Then anger comes in hand, in legs, and everywhere, it overcomes the whole body. This is very ulbar, very bhayanak. If one is controlled by calm, lust or greed, that person is not very harmful to others. But one who is controlled by anger, he is very harmful to others. other persons run away from him. Yes. Otherwise he can catch any danda, stick or anything and beat something. And if he does not find any stick, he just slaps and he kicks with legs. So this is called ulvaram, very fearful anger. The one who can control this anger, actually he can transcend the three modes of material nature. So gunan ativartate, atma jigyasa. But how to control anger? Atma jigyasa. That means self-realization. One should consider his position, what he is. A living entity is naturally the servant of Krishna. Jivera Swarup Hai Krishna Nitya Das. So when one thinks that he is master, he is controller, then anger arises. Otherwise, anger cannot come. So this anger comes suddenly, just like it falls from the sky in the body. Please subdue your anger and just try to transcend the modes of material nature. Just try to plead or satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is my request. I am not instructing you. Alam tadhar drumay dina khilanam shivamastuva. There is no need to burn these poor trees any longer. Let whatever trees still remain be happy. And you should also be happy. Just subdue your anger, you should become happy, all these trees should become happy. And at last he said, this girl who is very beautiful, named Marisa, I offer you this girl and you should accept this girl as your wife, Patnitya Pratigriyata. Just like the Supreme Personality of Godhead said that you should marry one girl, so the master of plants and trees, he is offering during Kanyadhan to Prachetas. Please accept this girl as your wife. So Tebhya Tasyam Samuvat Daksha Prachet Sakra. Thus they were satisfied. And when Som returned his home, then they married with that girl according to the principles of dharma. Dharmeṇa upiye mire. Dharmeṇa upiye mire. We should just consider the topics of Śrīmad Bhagavatam. Dharmeṇa. Sukadeva Goswami is saying, dharmeṇa, according to the principles of dharma, they married that girl, whose name was Marisa. And actually she was maintained by trees. She was born from an apsara named Pramlocha. By Kandu Rishi, but they both left that baby. The Kandu Rishi was a Rishi, so he did not accept that baby, and Apsara also did not accept. She also just put off three of the baby. So all the Vriksha trees, they maintain that baby girl. Som is offering that girl to Prachetas and they married with her according to the principles of dharma. And by their semen, one child was born, his name was Daksha Prajapati. First Daksha Prajapati was born as a son of Lord Brahma, directly from his body. But he offended Lord Shiva, so he got the head of a goat. This was not good for him. Anywhere Daksha visited, they were attacking, oh, this offended Lord Shiva, so he got the head of a goat. Daksha Prajapati became very upset and he just gave up his body And again he took birth as the son of Prachita. There were 10, but son was one. But very, very powerful son, and he helped Lord Brahma in creation. So the answer is coming this way, that Lord Brahma created living entities with the help of Daksha Prajapati, Bhrigu, Angira, Pula, Kratu, and Daksha Prajapati was the main of them, chief of them. So this is a story, but how Daksha Prajapati performed austerity in Vindhya Parvat, and then he married, and then he begot 10,000 sons to create living entity. But Narad ji polluted twice. Narad Muni instructed them to remain brahmachari, don't become grihastha. Daksha Prajapati, then again by the request of Lord Brahma, begot 1,000. But again Narad Muni instructed them to become brahmachari. Then he begot 60 daughters. Among them is Aditi, Diti, so many exalted women. And thus the whole universe was filled with population. This story is further explained in Śrīmad Bhagavatam. How Daksha Prajapati offered a prayer, very famous prayer, Hans Guhya Stuti. Just like we pray Krishna by Brahma Sanghita. Same way Daksha Prajapati offered a prayer that was not composed by Daksha Prajapati, that is found in Veda, Hans Guhya Stuti, very nice Stuti. Now we finish here. Hare Krishna, thank you very much.
I have a question. After having a direct instruction or having darshan of Supreme Lord, how some pure elevated Krishna consciousness devotee can be influenced by modes of material nature? Is there a reaction or is it?
No, that was necessary actually. Some field was required to produce grains. Otherwise, everywhere some weeds and trees, some land was required. So we should not think that prachetas were in the mode of ignorance, anger. Sometimes some instruction is given to other persons in the name of someone. Just like in Sanskrit, it is called kanya-vadhu-nyaya. Kanya-vadhu-nyaya, kanya means daughter. And vadhu means
wife.
Not. The wife of son.
Daughter-in-law.
So one sas. Sas means
mother-in-law.
There is no any English word, only in-law. In-law, one is mother, or father, or brother, but without law, no. In-law. So there was sas, mother-in-law. She wanted to instruct her vadhu, the wife of her son. She wanted to instruct, but she did not found any way how to instruct. So one day, her daughter came to her house. So she began to instruct her daughter, Betty, when you go to your mother-in-law's house, please serve your mother-in-law. And her daughter-in-law was listening. She was instructing her daughter, when you go to Sasural, Sasural means
in-laws.
When you go to your father-in-law's house, you should serve your mother-in-law, father-in-law. And if they speak some hard words, you should tolerate. You should sleep less. You should eat less. You should clean house. You should clean pots, clean cloth in this way. And don't use any hard words to your mother-in-law, father-in-law. So in this way, she was instructing her vadhu, her daughter-in-law actually. So in this way, in Śrīmad Bhagavatam, this teaching is given to Pracheta. This is not real thing. Actually, this is given to us. This is for us. One day I was speaking in Bombay. Vasudevji is pacifying or instructing Kamsa not to kill Devaki. He has spoken so nice instruction on soul and body. One devotee asked me, if Kamsa did not understand, why this philosophy is in Srimad Bhagavatam? Kamsa did not understand. I replied, this is for you and me, this is not for Kamsa. This philosophy is in Srimad Bhagavatam for us, not for Kamsa or Hiranyakasipu, for this, that. So this instruction is actually meant for us. It's not meant for Prachetas.
I have one more question. The life of trees that you have explained, it seems like the whole Srimad Bhagavatam or the whole Vedic teachings are mostly for the human beings, not for trees. But trees got more far superior in that sense life than human beings, because they are providing, they are tolerating, they are not complaining or anything. Why it was given in evolutionary theory like lowest than mankind? Just curious. I mean, I know Krishna is always right, but just still. I mean, they don't go back to Godhead as soon they die. I mean, they don't as soon they leave their body, gross body.
I cannot answer. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is instructing in Sikshastakam, Trinadapi Suni Chena Taro Riva Saisuna, Amalina Amani Dena Kirtani Sadahari. One should become humbler than a grass in the street and more tolerant than a tree. Means we should take lessons, but actually the life of trees, very painful, very ignorant life, very lowest consciousness. But we should learn from them how they are used in human society and how they are eaten by animals, how they are providing. They are not willingly or consciously they are providing, but they are used in so many ways. Your question is that why they do not go to Godhead when they leave their body, if they are serving in this way. Actually, they are not serving in consciousness. But we should think that they have very successful life. They are maintaining others, so we should also learn, we should also try to maintain, to help, to support other living entities. Why they are considered lower? This is the grade. Trees are on lowest life. They have to tolerate everything. They cannot move, they cannot run away. If anyone comes and just uses axe to cut, they cannot scream, they cannot run. They have to tolerate sun, they have to tolerate rain, cold, fasting, everything. But just see, Lord Krishna has said twice in Śrīmad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, how they are protecting us. In summer he was going on the bank of Jamuna, and the trees were like umbrellas. They were protecting from sunlight. So the Lord was instructing his friends, you see, O Bharata, Arjun, Vishal, Rishabh, Devprastha, Bharata, just see trees. Actually, their life is very successful. They give a leaf. Vaishnavas generally eat all leaves in India. And they give bark, they give wood, they give so many things, medicine. So in this way one should give everything for other living entities.
I have one more question.
Please excuse me. Merely doing everything for everybody does not give the capacity to liberate to go back to God. You must really love God. But please accept people. They do the congregation pretending. They are very good. Mere being good is no good. This is the answer.
Thank you. Can I ask one more question? When I walk or drive, I can also think that Krishna lives in my heart, in chitta. Now, if I kill an ant, if I well, not realize, but thinking that Krishna is also in my heart and I am next to him, my position is sadhana. I'm serving him. Am I considered to get reaction of the animal I'm killing, like an ant or something?
Why not?
But I'm a
servant. See God in your heart, and but you do not see God in ant's heart. Ishwar is not only in your heart. He is saying that he is in everyone's heart. You must see this. This is for perfect vision. But in your heart, you should not see that God is there. You are there, His servant. And also God is there. But thinking that God is in my heart, so you can forget yourself and you can think that I am God. It's better to see God in others' heart. There is a nice story about Sripad Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya said, he was instructing his disciples, just see Brahma everywhere. Sarvam Khalidam Brahma. You should see Brahma, Ishwar, God everywhere. So you should not fear or should not become dim, wretched. There was one disciple who accepted this philosophy but not fully. Once he was going through a road and a mad elephant was coming. It is true history. My elephant was gone, so the elephant driver told him, just run away, this elephant is mad, elephant is mad. The disciple said, I see everywhere God, I see everywhere Brahma, I see Brahma in elephant, so why I should run away? God is not fearful. I see Brahma everywhere. I see Brahma in elephant. I see Brahma in myself. And I see Brahma everywhere. But the driver was saying, just go away, go away, go away. But he said, no, 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 I see Brahma everywhere. Brahma is in elephant. So he reached near elephant and the elephant wrapped him with his trunk and threw him to some place. Oh, he was hurt this way. So he returned to Śrīmad Śankaracārya's and he just complained. You said everywhere is Brahma, everywhere is Brahma, but why this elephant hurt me? This is not good instruction. You said in elephant there is Brahma. Śrīmad Śankaracārya asked, oh, you see Brahma in elephant. And did you see Brahma in the driver? Brahma was directly forbidding him and he did not accept. Brahma was directly telling you, just leave the world, go away, but you do not have perfect vision, you do not see Brahma everywhere. So in this way, you should not speak this thing that if I kill an ant and if I am Krishna conscious, so there will be no reaction. Of course, bhakti destroys all sins, but willingly you should not commit sinful activities.
But then life will be paralyzed.
Paralyzed?
Well, you can move. I mean, there is insects everywhere. There is a grass. There is a plants. We have to be like tree. Yes, I
understand. Krishna has instructed Arjuna, just fight and remember me. Arjuna could say that if I remember you, then I am paralyzed. I will fight. And then killing and remembering can go together. Tasmat sarve sukale sumamanusmar juddhacha. One should not kill willingly or unnecessarily, but if you are going to your duty, you have to go, and there are four wide wheels of car, so many insects come inside chakka, inside wheels. Actually, you are going on road but killing so many insects. But here, what one can do? As you say that life will become paralyzed or like hell. No, we have to do our duty. It depends on time and circumstances and path, the candidates. Arjuna was hesitating to kill his kinsman, but Krishna inspired him, just go on killing and you will not suffer by the reactions of sins. Aham tvam sarvapapebhyo mokshayishyami mam sucha. If we conduct our duty or bhajan or our job, and if some killing is there, that is permitted by God, but we should not just kill any animal to eat or kill unnecessarily trees or insect any. Just like there is cooking. That is why grihastha is called grihamedhi according to Bhagavatam. Medhi, medhi means hinsa, killing. Medhatir hinsaya. A grihastha has to kill five times when he cooks, so many insects are burnt cooking, and when he collects water, at that time so many germs are killed. And personally, when one dwindles masala, at that time, anyone sweeps. Thus, everywhere a grihastha has to kill some insects. Not just for killing purpose, but he is performing his duty. But so many insects are killed. That is forbidden. But if one willingly kills cockroaches or other rats, then he has to suffer.
He also says in Bhagavad Gita that if you perform your prescribed duty and see any sin committed, you are not implicated.
What means Joseph? In Bhagavad Gita, what he said?
Krishna says, if you perform your prescribed duties, by performing your duties, if you commit any sin, then you are not implicated. Means you are not, you will not have a reaction.
Where? In which verse?
He meant, karmanya evadi karasthi mahapalishya karasthi. But that's not exactly the same.
No. There is another verse. I don't remember.
So dharma is also not killing.
The prescribed duties. Like Kshatriyas has to fight and kill. So he is performing his prescribed duties.
Duty means order of God. Duty means order of God.
18th chapter says he kills in the beginning of 18th chapter. If he doesn't have false ego, it says, then he's not.
No, because he is following the order of God, Krishna. Suppose a judge has given order for some person to crucify, and if some other person crucified that person, he does not suffer. There is no any suffering. So in this way, one who is really performing duty, he is performing order of God or his representative. And if a performing order, there is some killing or something unjust, that is forbidden.
It's also about Vaishya, he said.
That is
in the business, if you have, in your business, you have to tell lies, you know, sometimes.
But who has set up orders for business?
The Krishna's order.
Krishna's order. If Krishna's order is there is no sin.
Vaishyas, prescribed duties to do business.
Vaishyas should do business, but what kind of business? His representatives will decide what kind of business. A Vaishya's dharma is to protect cows, to produce grains and have business. Krishi Kulach Banijan, Vaishya Karma Swabhavajan. To Gorakshya and Krishi in Banij. Banij means he should produce some things and he should sell something from here to there, from there to here. This is all Banij. But that should also be done according to the Vedic order. But also it depends on circumstances, time, place, candidates. So Maharaj was same person right that we should not think this thing, we should just chant a continued devotional service. That was very nice answer. Otherwise, there is no any end of these topics and Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, please forgive me for any mistake. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much for coming to Radha. Maharaj is here on the 15th, so he'll be giving Śrīmad Bhagavatam class in the temple day after tomorrow, which is Thursday and Friday. There is a program at Mahaprabhu's house Saturday evening at 6, starting at 6 p.m. So these are the programs for now, and then we will keep you updated on all the others.